Look, see, I remember when I met you as a sophomore. Started out as friends, but I knew that we would want more. Hit your favorite restaurant.
I'm finally making the guide, which I was excited the most for. JETT, one of the most fast-paced agents in Valorant, with the infamous ultimate ability that sees her wiping out entire squads at critical times. But with such high skill ceiling, you need to learn everything there is to learn about her in order to start to master her. Hence this guide video that I put together to give you all the help you need to be able to carry as JETT, regardless of her somewhat difficult learning curve. Without further ado, let's start by knowing what her four skills do. Starting with her signature ability, Tailwind. Instantly dash in the direction she's moving. Note that if you are standing still, you dash forward. But also, Tailwind doesn't work vertically, so you cannot move up or down with it. The strongest use for Tailwind is escaping bad encounters quickly. For example, you are getting shot and you're a split second from dying. As JETT, you can just blink away. As any other character, you die. Even though you can blink in 8 different directions, the 4 cardinals and the 4 diagonals, but you might still be a bit predictable to some players, especially the ones that play JETT. So try jumping either at the start or during the boost to help you be a slightly less predictable target. Always know where you are dashing to and take your destination into account, as Valorant counterbalance Tailwind by decreasing your momentum at the end of the boost, as you can't transition from Tailwind straight into a bunny hop. And also, there is a 1 second delay following the boost before you can use your weapon, so maybe dash into a safe corner or a cover. One last thing you really need to consider: vision distortion. While boosting with Tailwind, your vision is distorted slightly, and no, turning distortion off in Valorant graphic settings doesn't remove this. So try to be aware of your environment and have an idea of where the enemy is before using Tailwind. Moving on to the one thing that caught my attention when Valorant was first announced, JETT's ultimate, Bladestorm. Equip a set of highly accurate throwing knives that recharge on killing an opponent. Fire to throw a single knife at your target, and alternate fire to throw all remaining knives at your target. Each knife of Bladestorm deals 50 damage on body shots and 150 damage per headshot, so if you land a knife in your enemy's head, it's a guaranteed kill. On paper, Bladestorm is worse than most guns, especially if you can't aim for shit. Its one great benefit is that the knives are always 100% accurate and doesn't suffer from movement inaccuracy or recoil. Therefore, it's a very good idea to combine your ultimate with Tailwind or Updraft, which I will be explaining next. As the mobility doesn't affect your accuracy in any way, the only thing that affects it is your aim. Bladestorm can lead to epic and intense team wiping clutches, as your knives replenish when you kill someone with them, making it the one time you bring a knife to a gunfight and actually win. As clicking fire to throw a knife is great for long range combat, but Bladestorm can be extremely useful in close range trading, as right clicking to fire turns Bladestorm into a shotgun that throws knives in scattershot manner. This is extremely powerful in very close quarters, and you can often score a kill by camping close to a corner for the enemy to round it and then boom. To counter the weapon using delay following Tailwind, you can use Bladestorm, as the delay is far less pronounced. And also, Bladestorm has no timer like certain other ultimate abilities, so you can take your time while Bladestorm is active. Note that there is a significant wind-up animation after activating Bladestorm before the knives can actually be thrown, around 1.5 seconds, and there is a similar delay after the knives are depleted before you can use your regular weapon again. So if you mess up with your Bladestorm, you can very easily be punished for it. High risk, high reward. Now moving on to the purchasables, starting with Updraft, instantly boosts JETT high in the air. Basically, you click to jump higher than natural, which can give you more freedom to move around the map, and you can supplement Updraft with JETT's passive float ability to stay in the air for a longer time. As with Tailwind, Updraft ability has a delay for around 1 second after animation before you can use your weapon again, so be careful. The reason Updraft can be very useful is its flexibility, as you can combine both jumps or one jump with Sage Wall or another boosting ability to reach very high. High enough to look over the tops of buildings in certain areas. The biggest downside to Updraft is that the moment you're in the air, you're subject to enormous movement inaccuracy, which means your shots with normal weapons will be extremely inaccurate. The effect is probably least potent with a shotgun like Bucky, which has led some JETT players to go floating and gunning with a Bucky. And now to the skill, Cloudburst. To add the last ninja element to JETT, you can equip an instantly through a projectile that expands into a brief vision cloud on impact with a surface. Hold the ability key to curve the cloud in the direction of your crosshair. Many Valorant players don't think much of cloud burst due to the smokes only lasting 4 seconds each. And they have a point, it's enough time to quickly relocate a short distance without enemies seeing you. You can curve the trajectory of a cloud burst for as long as you hold down the ability button after casting, but the moment you let go, you cannot control it anymore. Just like Phoenix plays, you can curve cloud burst very sharply around corners. Note that you don't have to be Omen to play mind games. You can deploy cloud burst as far as possible away from yourself to make enemies think you are near when you're not and take advantage of their confusion to flank them. Cloudburst smokes are hollow, but if you're inside one with a friend or foe, you'll be nearsighted until you leave the area of effect. And also, while navigating a cloudburst through the air, you are locked out of using weapons, but you can still move around. JETT has all the elements of a ninja: throwing blades, smoke bombs, blinking, jumping high, and floating in the air. Floating itself makes JETT quite special, as she gets to spots using only her passive that would normally require an ability. For example, she can reach the top of the boxes in the center of Haven's A site from the ground, while every other agent will have to use an ability or head up to A Haven to do so. And if you're also wondering, you need to climb the boxes in the very corner of A site, so don't use your abilities to get to these spots unless necessary. JETT is initiator, through and through. Her strength is in starting and ending fights quickly, and she's also surprisingly hard to kill if you're quick with Tailwind. But her skill set lacks the utility required to make her a top tier Valorant agent in the eyes of most players. You'll have to work hard and score lots of kills to prove your worth as JETT. This will be all. I hope you found this video helpful, as I know watching it is only the first step into mastering JETT. Practice is always the key. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Cheers!